stated it on our website, so I need to get that channel to work. Before we officially get started, just some announcements regarding procedures. Of course, we have exits at the front and the back of the room. And regarding after the ceremony, anyone wishing to sign their child out, we will be doing that from the classroom. The children will return to the classroom, and parents will then go to the classroom and do that quick check sign out. So to keep the water process along. But those are our procedural announcements. So without further ado, can I ask you all to please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Please be seated.
Try to share a little bit here and talk to the students and to our class. Dear students, parents, and family members, teachers, district administrators, board of ed members, honored community guests, it is my distinct pleasure to welcome you all to our class of 22's 2022 Giving Up Day ceremony. Before we begin, I'd be remiss if I didn't extend a heartfelt thank you to everyone here today who helped make this event possible, including our third grade teachers for all their hard work on the development of the program, awards, and video slideshow we were just watching, to Mr. Pignataro for his efforts with linking the slideshow to a QR code that you will find on today's program so that you can link to that and watch it anytime. Also for filming our event today for those who cannot be in attendance. To our music teacher, Mrs. Kroll, for leading the children in the singing of patriotic and uplifting songs you will hear this morning. To our art teacher, Ms. Ensworth, for working with the students to create the signature stars you see in front of the stage. And to Alex Finelli in the middle school for helping to cut those up for us. To our entire custodial staff for their help with setting up the risers and all the seating. To my secretarial team for their support with creating and printing the program and certificates today. And last, but certainly not least, to our awesome Moving Up Day parent committee, who rallied with the last minute change of venue and has worked tirelessly to plan this very creative Hollywood red carpet Walk of Fame themed celebration for all of our students and families to enjoy this afternoon. So a round of applause. When I first learned of this theme, and then as I thought more about it, I realized it's the perfect fit for this year's class. These students, right along with all of us, truly deserve to walk a red carpet today and feel exceedingly proud of the accomplishments made, because we have walked through quite a bit of adversity to get to this moment in time. Let's travel back for a minute. In 2018, these children walked through the doors of Greenwood Lake Elementary School and were unknowingly the last group of children to experience normal kindergarten, which I am so grateful for, as it gave them the strong foundation for what was ahead. During March of their first grade year, students, the world, school as we knew it, was shut down. Parents, teachers, and these precious children, who were so little, 5 and 6 year olds at the time, needed to be totally reinvent education remotely using technology platforms that were typically introduced in the final quarter of first grade and solidified in second and third grade. This sudden shift was a lot to absorb. We needed to adapt and find ways to work from home while fully supporting little children who were not independent learners yet. We needed help with everything we were asking them to do. We all had to multitask and ask for help and find ways to keep from going crazy. But we did it to the best of our abilities. And we learned the valuable lesson that in today's world, we need to be able to adapt to ever-changing circumstances. And that will always be loving adults who do their absolute best to do this, to solve it through the process. Second grade was the year of 6 feet apart, but closer than ever. Being in small cohorts with the same people for the whole year developed you into a very tight-knit learning community. We really got to know each other. Every classroom became like a little family. Figured out how to make and keep connections with others, even when they were challenged by distance, and how to recognize and process your emotions, and the importance of being respectful and helpful to your school, your family, and your community. And now in third grade, we've finally taken some steps for a return to pre-COVID school as we knew it. And the best part is getting to see each other's faces, smiling faces, for the first time in years. I recently read a book entitled David and Goliath, Underdogs, Misfits, and the Art of Battling Giants by Malcolm Gladwell. And the book focused on the probability of improbable events occurring in situations where one outcome is greatly favored over the other. Now, one could assume that this class of 2022 would fail academically and socially because the road they walked was littered with obstacles to their success. But as I look out over all of you underdogs, I can honestly say that you've battled a giant and come out on top. I have had the pleasure of getting to know you, have experienced firsthand the good people you are. I've watched you working in the classroom and playing with your friends at recess. You've shared your interests with me and your talents. Each and every one of you has a specialness that is uniquely yours, and you are all Greenwood Lake success stories. Principals are not supposed to say that they have favorites, but I have to admit that this class, your class in particular, will always have a special place in my heart because we arrived at Greenwood Lake at the same time. We have walked this road together. I was hired as principal of the school the summer before your kindergarten year. They say fire forges the strongest metal. We've walked through fire together and come out stronger because of it. You all have the persistence and grit to roll whatever challenges life may throw at you. And are extremely proud of the superstars you have become. Enjoy your walk of fame today. You all really deserve it. Remind you one more time to be respectful, be responsible, and be safe. And I hope you have a wonderful time celebrating your moving up to the middle school with your families today. At this time, I'd like to call up Superintendent Haddon, who would like to share some of our wishes as well.
Begin to shine. So today I want to talk to you about what it means to embrace yourself. So
we're going to practice celebrating yourself as an individual. Are you ready? This requires participation. You ready?
Yeah.
Okay. So, we're going to do this. We're going to say, in the whole wide world, there's nobody like me.
In the whole
wide world, there's nobody like me. Okay? So, throughout this speech, when I say, in this whole wide world, there's nobody like you, you're going to answer with what I just taught you. Ready? In this whole wide world, there's nobody like me. All right, I'm going to practice one more time so we do it together. In this whole wide world, there's nobody like me. Good. All right, so let's get to it. What makes you you? Every person is different. Every family is different. Some of you are the oldest child. Some of you are the youngest in your family. Some of you may be in the middle, or you could be the only child. Did you know that your place in the family is part of what makes you special and unique and gives you a very specific skill set when you get older? In this whole wide world, there's nobody like you.
Important Ms. Cologne's class, please rise. We just ask that you hold your applause for individual students until the entire class has been called for their certificates. Thank you. Reagan Bonema. Liam Buckley. Harlan Burkine. Brody Pasta. Heavenly Manitola. Aaliyah Person. Jake Wall. Presenting Mrs. Beacord and Ms. Cologne's third grade class. Bye. Daniel Boyle. Lucia Capelli. Paige Castro. I'd just like to mention we have one student who's not here today, but I want to honor him, Gino Di Mattina. That too. Dylan Hood. Jonathan Harrell. Adriana Jean Charles. Madeline Lucero. Sean Marino. McCaffrey. Michael Rapp.
Thank you.
Carly Perkins. Chloe
Thank you.
committed to putting forth her best self in all situations and has risen to challenges that come her way. She is a hard worker and perseveres when difficult circumstances present themselves. For a young girl, she shows strength of character, courage, and compassion beyond her years. This student was a remote student for 1.5 years in upstate New York before moving to Greenwood Lake and entering our school district. These environmental factors led to her rating being below grade level, but she recognized this and wanted to improve her skills. She worked diligently each day in class, during extra support time, and at home to improve. This student is also fluent in 2 languages, English and Spanish. She assists students in her class who may need translating, and she does this without being asked. She also teaches her grandmother how to speak English when at home. This student would someday like to be an engineer to improve the way we build cars, buildings, and medical devices to help people live happier lives. I'm happy to congratulate and give this deserving recognition to Michaela Nieto. Achievement Award. This award recognizes students who have shown academic excellence and the potential for leadership through involvement in activities that improve the school or community. Again, we have 3 recipients this year. This award goes to a student who strives to reach her full potential at all times. She not only works hard to reach her academic goals, but exceed them, but she uses her creativity as well to problem solve, show expression, and add more to her expectations. When this student is faced with a challenge, she will rise and bring others together to reach a common goal. Her smile and positivity keep others around her motivated and drawn to a task. Not only does she use her strengths to better our classroom community, but she also is involved in helping our local community as a Girl Scout member. With her group, she provides support with cleaning the community, learning about nature, and helping others in need. This student has an extensive extracurricular involvement. She enjoys expressing her talents in acting through our school drama club, as well as an outside drama club. She is also a part of many clubs, such as our Techno Kids Club, Culinary Club, and Girls to Read Club. She enjoys being physically active as well. Some of her involvements include, but are not limited to, gymnastics, softball, cheer, soccer. She favors gymnastics and acting as she shares many of her favorite events and days in those activities. This student is hardworking and deserving of recognition. It is with great pleasure that we award Riley Callenberg. Okay, this next student is committed to academic excellence. He is also actively involved in school and community activities. One would not be surprised to see him in a leadership role throughout his Greenwood Lake academic career. This student is a leader both in the classroom. He is a hard worker who is driven intrinsically to do his best. Although academics come easy for him, he never makes others feel below him. Rather, he always offers to help a friend in need or will provide a friendly hint or piece of advice. He wants to see his classmates improve upon their skills and be successful. He has respect for all and is considered a model student by his teachers. This student is also an active community member. He is a member of the local Boy Scouts and enjoys completing local community projects with his troop. He is also a dedicated soccer player. He never misses a practice, game, or the opportunity to cheer his teammates on. Jonathan Harrell is deserving of this award.
We're gonna make the future positively sing. We're gonna make the future positively sing.
will be greatly missed here at the elementary school and always welcome to return. We wish you the best of success in the middle school and we know we're going to do great, great things. And with that, that concludes our ceremony for this morning. I would be remiss one more time. I would like to let you know there were a number of parents involved in decorating and helping, but I would like to recognize Lisa Smith and Audrey Lang for their leadership. Here, especially my third grade team and my specialist team for all their work in making this ceremony possible as well. So, onward to our fun afternoon moving up day activities. And the students are going to be dismissing as they came in, coming through the center aisle. We ask that you remain in your seats until they have cleared the room. They will each be returning to their homerooms, and if you do wish to sign them out, we have sign-up sheets in the classrooms. So we'll just give them all to some of your student. Otherwise, of course, they're welcome to stay for the remainder of the day. So have a wonderful afternoon. Enjoy celebrating as families. Have a wonderful, healthy, safe summer. See some of you here at the middle school. It's been wonderful.